Scotland's capital, Edinburgh, is rich in history. But this brand new building is very much looking to the future. The Scottish Centre for Regenerative Medicine is at the cutting edge of health technology. This state-of-the-art laboratory is dedicated to a revolutionary procedure, growing blood.
What we're talking about is real human red blood cells, but produced through a culture process rather than donated on a day-by-day basis by donors like you and I.
At the Blood Donor Centre here in Edinburgh and across the developed world, there's a well-established system of blood donation. But as their populations age, more people will need blood and fewer will be able to donate it. The Scottish team think that one day their work may make it possible to do away with blood donating altogether.
The biggest issue with blood supply is that we use 2 million bags of blood a year. And each of those bags of blood has 2 trillion red blood cells in it. So these are immense numbers of cells that we would need to replace the current donor blood service. However, what we have is the human embryonic stem cell, which has the capacity to just grow and grow and increase in number endlessly in the laboratory as long as we treat them correctly.
In poorer countries, there's already a critical shortage of blood. No one knows how many deaths this causes. Blood donations are few, and keeping them free from infections is a constant struggle. Growing stem cells and turning them into blood could be the answer.
Stem cells are the cells in our bodies which both can replicate themselves indefinitely and can also, as we say, differentiate, that is, mature into all the different kinds of cells, 200 or so different kinds of cells in your body.
What we then have to do is to turn that cell, which we call pluripotent, because it can turn into anything, we have to ask it to specifically only turn into red blood cells. So for example, your bone marrow, which is where your blood's made, is making 2 million new red blood cells every second of every day. So we have to recreate the environment that the cells would be seeing within your bone marrow that says, become red blood cells. So they start off being completely unspecialized and able to turn into anything, and they end up being just red blood cells. And then we can use those red blood cells and take them and package them up in a blood bag as we would with donated blood and use them for transfusion.
Nurturing stem cells in a series of liquid cultures encourages them to develop into red blood cells. The challenge for the new lab is to do this on a much bigger scale and in a way that is clinically safe, because the aim is for human trials.
Currently, we're producing around 100,000 million red blood cells, or 1 to 2 mils of blood, perhaps up to 5 mils of blood. So that would be a teaspoonful of blood. But when you think that, for example, in an average blood transfusion, there's about 2.5 million red blood cells, you can see that we still have some way to go in terms of scaling up that process.
The team uses embryonic stem cells left over from a fertility clinic and that would otherwise be destroyed. And it's in the new centre that they hope to take the venture to the next level. The aim is not for teaspoonfuls, but whole bags of usable blood.
I think that the need for blood is just not going to go away. It's an absolute mainstay of modern medicine. So as long as we have that requirement, we're going to have to think of a way to meet it. And this seems to be a very viable option.